بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نكمل اليوم. بدنا نتحدث عن موضوعين. موضوع the criteria of research objectives, and we'll talk about the importance of having theory and about how to write a research proposal. وكيف نكتب research proposal. Okay. As you know from the previous meeting, we have five measures of SMART which helping us to refine our research questions. Our research question must be specific, direct, specific by the terminology that you are using. Okay? Don't use vague keywords or concepts that is not understandable by people, by authors, and you can measure it. Let's say for instance, I will give you some examples how you can do the measurements. I'm doing a research about the economic empowerments. Economic empowerment for youth, okay? So it's specific to the economic empowerment. In order to have a clear research questions, we can say, for instance, what are, for instance, the factors of economic empowerment for youth. So we are asking about the factors, or what are the dimensions? What are the dimensions? Factors or dimensions? Now we need to deconstruct the economic empowerments. I mean, we need to measure. First of all, you have to have a clear definition of economic empowerment. Who define it? Because we have different meanings, we have different definitions, we have different understanding of the economic empowerment. Then when you are revising your literature, you have to have a specified definition or meaning for the utilized economic empowerment, the one that you are using in your research. Then the measures. In the measures, we have different measures or different dimensions of economic empowerment. For instance, we have financial literacy. Financial literacy. We have economic literacy. We have economic sufficiency or economic sufficient. And we have economic efficacy. So this is the construction of economic empowerment. For each one, we have measurements for financial literacy. Financial literacy is much related to the financial knowledge. In order employees or in order youth having economic empowerment, they should be financially literate or literal. يعني لازم يكون هم واعيين ماليا. Okay, for instance, one of the measures we can ask, you have bank accounts. This is measure. If you have bank account, you can say yes or no. So I measure that if you have a bank account, it means you have a financial literacy. Okay, another question. Two. You had course in financial or personal finance? Personal finance. لا, الفاينانشال ليترسي هي الوعي المالي او الثقافه الماليه.
عندك
اذا عندك حساب بنكي بيكون عندك وعي مالي. طيب, إذا أخذت كورس مثلا في الفاينانس أو بيرسونال فاينانس بكون عندي وعي مالي، تمام؟ فهدول بسموهم measures. Also the research question should be achievable. As you see here, we have different dimensions for economic empowerment, and if we deconstruct them, we have different measures. The question is, you can measure them at what at one time or not. You could end with 75 measures. Can you measure them? Achievable, it means much related to the time and the cost. يعني مرتبطة في الوقت وفي الجهد اللي ممكن انتو تبذلوه. And the last things is, or the realistics. تكون واقعي في البحث تبعك. Can you answer this research question? You have the skills to do this? Can you cover the literature review related to these items or not? So it's much related to the to your skills, much related to your understanding, much related to be real. Can you apply the questionnaire or you can apply the different tools to achieve this research questions or not? The time help you, your efforts, how much it cost. And this is leads us to the theory, the importance of theory. شو يعني انه احنا تكون نظرية؟ اي ظاهرة اقتصادية او اجتماعية او ادارية, business and economics, it should be a theory explain this research problem or research question. يعني لازم يكون في نظرية, زي النظريات الموجودة في الماركتينج, زي النظريات الموجوده بالفاينانس والنظريات الموجوده في الـ في الـ في الاتش ار وفي المانجمنت انفورميشن سيستم. The basic question whether you understand the theory related to your subject or not. هل انتم فاهمين النظريه اللي لها علاقه في الموضوع تبعكم ولا لا؟ فاذا احنا بنحكي مثلا في الايكونوميك امباورمنت, this is related to the theories of economics. Okay, and theories of youth. لأنه economic empowerment for youth and is much related also in the theories of finance, كمان النظريات تبعت الفاينانس. وبالتالي when you are starting your research, it's important to know you the theory that you will apply. Sometimes there is a theory explain the business and economic issues, and sometimes there is no theory. Okay, so if you have theory, if you have theory, it means you are deductive. Okay, if you don't have theory, so you are inductive. So what it means you have theory and you don't have theory. If you have theory, it means the theory explains the, let's say, the research question or the business and economic issues. يعني بتكون في نظريات انعملت, هذه النظريات اللي انعملت بتفسر المشاكل الاقتصادية والمشاكل الإدارية اللي بتصير في الشركات. يعني زي مثلا نقول كل مرة بنحكي الموتيفيشن والإنجاز. هذه it's a part of theory, هذه جزء من النظرية. And sometimes we don't have theories explain the business and economic issues. في بعض الحالات ما عندنا نظريات تتفسر, because it's sometimes it's a new new issue or new problem. ممكن أشياء جديدة, وخاصة because of the introduction of technology, بسبب تدخل التكنولوجيا علينا. Okay, ممكن ما نجد حلول أو ما نجد تفسيرات لا المشاكل الحديثة الموجودة عندنا. So we need to build the theory. هنا إذا if we don't have theory, we need to build the theory. But in the deductive, we need to test the theory. Okay? So this is the importance of theory. And theory, it's much related to the explanations or previous explanations of others or the scientific experience from others. النظرية هي عبارة عن تفسيرات علمية لظواهر اقتصادية وإدارية صار اختبار إلها أوكي من قبل علماء الإدارة والاقتصاد والمحاسب طبعا أوكي. وبالتالي هذه هي بتعطينا the importance of theories. The majority of people the majority of researchers having theory and they are testing the theory, therefore they are deductive. Okay, يعني أغلب الأبحاث اللي بتصير يعني تقريبا 95% من الأبحاث بما فيها أبحاثكم هي عبارة عن testing the theory. يعني أنتوا testing the models أو testing اختبار لنماذج. And 5% of the research around the globe is inductive. Which means building theory. يعني هي احنا بنوجد النظرية. And in doing this, sometimes the question is helping us to determine which natural or which type of theory we should have. For instance, if we use what, okay, so it's much related to the descriptive. Okay? What? عادة احنا we asking about facts, حقائق. And when you are using why is using beyond the what? Okay? Let's go back to the importance of economic empowerments. Economic empowerments for youth, يعني اللي هو التمكين الاقتصادي للشباب أو للwomen ممكن. إحنا مش عارفين. فممكن نسأل what is the economic empowerment for women? What is the economic empowerment for youth? يعني إيش هو ما هو وضع التمكين الاقتصادي للشباب أو للمرأة؟ يعني هل هي عندها economic literacy ولا ما عندهاش؟ هل هي عندها financial literacy ولا ما عندهاش؟ هل هي عندها economic sufficiency ولا لا؟ هل عندها economic efficacy ولا لا؟ هل عندها financial vulnerability ولا لا؟ We should know. We don't know now. بس بدنا نعرف what is the level of her financial literacy. يعني هل عندها وعي مالي؟ أو هل عنده وعي مالي ولا لا؟ كثير مهم السؤال. And then after that, after describe what is the level of financial literacy, then we can go beyond the financial literacy. For instance, if we observe that, and this is research, I done this research 1 year ago. What we observed? We observed that the financial literacy of youth is low. Okay? Is low. ضعيف. يعني مثلا انه هم even some people have financial course. حتى الناس اللي عندهم financial course يعني ماخذين financial management. لكن تعال قول له مثلا بتعرف تتعامل مع البنوك؟ بتعرف اجراءات القرض؟ بتعرف كيف تحصل على تمويل؟ This is the financial literacy. بتعرف مثلا يعني تدير السيفنجز تبعتك او بتعرف مثلا تدير الاوبليجيشنز حتى الالتزامات الماليه تبعتك، تقدر تدير الاسره ماليا. All of these financial literacy. And we observe it's low. منخفضه. يعني الوعي المالي عندهم ايش؟ منخفض. And sometimes the economic literacy, what we observe, the economic literacy is low. The economic literacy. يعني ايش الايكونوميك ليتراسي از لو؟ يعني لما انا بتيجي على قناه الجزيره في بيجوا اخبار اقتصاديه، في الاخبار الاقتصاديه بقول والله الجي دي بي انخفض، والجي دي بي do you know what it means جي دي بي and you graduate from business and economic school وانتم مخلصين من business and economic school so it's shame that you don't understand what Al Jazeera saying and in our research what we observed that the economic literacy is low even for business and economic students and we have a focus let's say we have what they called a particular group is to compare between the people who engage in the university and people who not engage in the university. We see no difference. It's amazing. There is no difference between people who join the universities or students or people who are not joining the schools or universities in terms of economic literacy. If you ask people from engineering school, what is GDP? But GDP is important to know because it's have influence in their life. What is the economic growth? And this is for very basic things presented by Al Jazeera. Now this is what? What is the level? We describe the financial literacy, the economic literacy, etc. So the why is coming now. Okay, why the financial literacy is low? Why the economic literacy is low? Why the economic sufficiency is low? So we are going beyond. What is the relationship between the what and why? Yes, what is descriptive? Therefore, we can apply a quantitative research. We can apply quantitative research. But when you go beyond or underneath the problems, you need qualitative research. You can sit down with bringing some youth and asking them why you don't have economic literacy. Despite you join the school. برغم انه انتم كنتوا في المدرسة او في الجامعة. ممكن يقول والله احنا كنا بس نمتحن عشان الامتحان. مثلا انه انتم اخذتوا في مادة اسمها Finance and Banking. How you start or how you open a bank account. ممكن تقول اوكي صحيح بس احنا ما رحناش عملي انه احنا نشوف كيف نفتح بنك او نفتح حساب في بنك. اوكي؟ So it's a matter of understanding why people have lower financial literacy and economic literacy. In the same vein, when we are talk about motivation and performance, so we may ask, what is the relationship between motivation and performance? If the result saying there is a weak relationship, then we invite Y to come to investigate why there is a weak relationship. So now I think you should understand or differ between what a question and why a question. السؤال what is different and سؤال why. Because why is going beneath or underneath the problems or the research question. Okay, in order to, we have what and why, in order to explain the phenomena or the business and economic problems, predict outcomes. Predict outcomes, إنه إحنا نتنبأ في النتائج. يعني مثلا خلينا نيجي predict outcomes. The people they have financial literacy, الناس اللي عندهم financial literacy, they have economic sufficiency. يعني الناس اللي عندهم وعي مالي، اوكي، عندهم مثلا اكتفاء اقتصادي. يعني مثلا راتبهم 500 دولار. بيعرفوا هم كيف يعملوا سيفنج، بيعرفوا كذا، عندهم financial literacy. بعدين هذا بكفيهم. بيقدروا، يعني اعطيكم امثله على الفاينانشال سفشنسي. بيقدروا انه اخر الاسبوع يروحوا يعزموا حد من اصدقائهم، بيقدروا انه هم يمارسوا بعض الرياضه البيت سبورت، بيقدروا هم ياكلوا اكل طبيعي، بيقدروا 1 2 3 4 بسموها ايكونوميك سافيشنسي. تمام؟ ليش؟ لانهم عندهم فاينانشال ليتراسي. اذا في عندي علاقتين، فهي احنا بنسميها بريدكت اوتكمز، علاقه بين شغلتين او نتائج معينه ممكن تاثر على مكان. بيكوز يو هافينج فاينانشال ليتراسي ممكن يكون عندي، بيكوز كومبانيز for instance they know how to use digital marketing, okay, so their revenues will increase. فهي الاوتكمز، لانه المانجرز اللي عندهم فهم للديجيتال ماركتينج ممكن الريفينيوز تبعتهم تتحسن. But if you don't know, okay, about the digital marketing, so the question of what is the use of digital marketing in the business? We want to know whether the business is using digital marketing or not. Then, if the high use of digital marketing, we should observe the outcome of this. بدنا نشوف الاوتكمز تبعتها. So what is the outcome of having knowledge or having experience in digital marketing? Your revenues will increase. So this is the connections. Okay? So the more you read about your theory or about your research problems, the more you have connections. And this has helped you analyze relationships between variables, as I mentioned. Digital marketing increase the communication with customers. If you apply digital marketing or if you have experience on digital marketing, you facilitate the connections with the customers. So this is the relationship. Having more customers. And so compare and generalize. Then you can compare between companies, you can compare between individuals, you can compare between groups, institutions, okay? And you generalize. For instance, let's go back about the financial literacy. People with the high financial literacy, they may have economic or high economic sufficiency. Okay? And people with low financial literacy, they have low economic sufficiency. يعني أعطيكم أمثلة بسيطة. Financial literacy بالضبط. يعني لو واحد راتبه مثلا 500 دولار 2000 شيكل، الفاينانشال ليترسي بتقول انه ممكن يستخدم، يكون عنده فاتح حساب بنكي له، انه 400 دولار ممكن يحطهم يشتغل فيهم. يعني هاي ليترسي، هاي يعني خبره او فهم مالي. 100 دولار يحطها از سيفنج. طب اذا هو ما بيعرفش كيف يستخدم البنك اكاونتس، ممكن يروح يعمل سيفنج في مكان ما، لكن هذا it could be risk. تمام؟ يعني ممكن يحطها في فوق الشباك، يحطها في مكان، اجى بدناش نقول تنسرق، يعني انه اجى ريح وراحت ال 100 دولار وما شفناهاش على سبيل المثال. او مثلا يعني حطها في مكان ما وال and get lost. ايه؟
خباها مع امه وامه
صارت، او بالضبط، او خباها مع امه او مع جدته، وامه شي financially stressed وصار عندها ضغط مالي. And for instance her daughter she's busy and she wants this $100, she paid to her. تمام؟ هاي if he knows or if she knows how to use the $100 and open an account, it's saving. Okay? In this case, in the future, if he wants to pay the tuition fees, so there is a money is saved in his bank account. He can use it. So this is economic sufficiency. يعني مش هيحتاج يروح يعمل borrowing من ناس آخرين. مش هيروح. طيب نرجع كمان مرة ل 400 دولار اللي ضلوا معاه. Whatever. ممكن يجي المدام في البيت تقول له والله بدنا نشتري يعني نشتري ملح وسكر. قديش مثلا؟ كلها 10 شيكل. بقول لا معيش مصاري. بعد خمس دقائق بروح بيعطي ابنه روح اشتري علبه دخان. قديش حاجة 15 شيكل. إحنا we are not talking about the importance of this and this. We are talking about how to balance your expenses. كيف أنت تعمل ال balance between your expenses. قديش بكون عندي financial literacy, قديش بكون عندي economic sufficiency in management of my financial resources. يعني قديش إنه إحنا بنعمل management لل financial resources, للموارد المالية, حتى لو كانت very little. حتى لو كانت إيش؟ very little, يعني كانت بسيطة ومحدودة. Okay? Then, they generalize when we have different groups, مجموعات مختلفة, with different criteria, مع مواصفات محددة, ممكن إحنا نعمل مقارنات بيناتهم. عشان نعمل generalizability أو generalizing for our findings. نقول والله الناس اللي مثلاً اللي أخذوا كورس بالكورسات بالفاينانس وخاصة البيرسونال فاينانس هدول بيقدروا يديروا يكون عندهم كفاءة اقتصادية في إدارة البيت تبعهم. الناس اللي عندهم حسابات في البنك وعندهم يعني إدارة لمشاريع وكذا الكفاءة الاقتصادية تبعتهم عالية. تمام؟ فهي في والناس اللي ما راحوش ما اخذوش الفاينانشال كورسز ولا هم بتطلعوا على اخبار اقتصاديه ولا و الى اخره ما عندهمش فاينانشال ليترسي وبالتالي عندهم مشكله في الايكونوميك سافيشنسي. تمام. Why I'm giving you these examples because it's important to you. كثير مهمه لكم because if you want to arrange a party إذا أنتم بكم مثلاً تعملوا احتفال بسيط should be related to your understanding of financial literacy. إلى علاقة في اللي فهمنا للفاينانشال ليترسي. يعني مثلاً إذا كان البادجت تبعتي 500 دولار الراتب يعني you should arrange this. If you want to buy a car also there is some rules is it doesn't exceed of for instance more than 10% from your wealth. يعني ما تزيدش عن 10% مثلا من الثروة الموجودة عندك. مش to borrow money and بالأخير begging money from people. وبعدين نروح إحنا. So this is the issue. So if you look back at about the Phillips and Boff, what they said, what and why are more important? In order to, what is the research problem? Predict the outcomes as I mentioned, then you find the relationship between X and Y, and then you can generalize about the this. I will give you another example. The developed countries, their people have high financial literacy. Developed countries, their people, إيش مالهم؟ high financial literacy. طب ليش؟ لأنه في schools بياخدوها في السكولز وفي اليونيفرسيتيز. يعني في سنة أولى كل الطلاب سنة أولى لازم ياخدوا بيرسونال فاينانس. ياخدوا إيش؟ بيرسونال فاينانس كيف تو مانج. وبعدين بيعرفوهم كيف تو أكسس تو فاينانس, كيف يتعرف على من وين يجيب المصاري. أوكي؟ So this is for all, even the schools in the primary school, in the secondary school and in the primary school and the secondary school. So in compare and generalize, we compare between developed countries and developing countries. And we observe the developing countries have less financial literacy than the developed countries. So this is a matter of comparing. So when you are dealing with your theory and you are dealing with your literature, you should ask or answer these questions. So, affirmating regarding the cause and effect, relationship between two or more variables which may or may not have been tested. إذا هي مجموعة من العلاقات بين أكثر من متغير ممكن تم اختبارها أو لم يتم اختبارها. بالضبط زي ما إحنا بنحكي عن في deductive. Theory, if you have theory, you are deductive. تمام؟ tested
deductive.
Okay, tested or not tested, يعني اختبرنا العلاقه او ما اختبرناش. Once you have theory you are deductive. طالما انه احنا عندنا theory deductive, لكن اجزاء الثيوري في بعض الحالات انه تم اختبارها وفي بعض الحالات لم يتم اختبارها. اوكي، هي الفكره في الثيوري. We have three, four typology of theories. We have a grand, mid-range, and substantive theories. A grand theory, it's like abstract. Abstract. And when you move from the substantive theory to grand theory, the capacity to change the way we think about the world. Increasing the capacity of understanding why things change. I will go in details about these things, but not in this chapter. In chapter 3 and 4, in chapter 4, we will discuss the different types of theories. In increasing restrictions in terms of generalize and applicability, because substantive theories is much related to a particular issue. In a particular time. So it's a subject of limitations and subject of less generalizability. يعني هي معرضة إنه تكون محدودة في تفسيراتها لظواهر ظهرت زمنيا ومكانيا ومحددة مش ظواهر عامة. A grand theory it's a basic theory and abstract يعني نظريات عامة ونظريات يعني بتعطي بعض النماذج اللي تتسم في العموميه. We will go back in this. Deductive approach and inductive approach. I explain the deductive and inductive approach. As we mentioned before, if you have a clear theory, then you are deductive. My little question to the students, when you are reading, do you think it's complicated on putting your hands on the theory, or it's simple? يعني هل تعتقدوا انه سهل ولا صعب انه احنا نحصل على الثيوري؟ complicated. My question is: easily to you to know the theory related to your subject? Yes. بالضبط ممكن يساعدونا الأساتذة. For a student, generally, it's challenging to them on putting their hands on the theory. يعني بتكون صعبة شوية إنه هم يحطوا إيديهم على الثيوري على النظرية. But how we can challenge this problem by more reading? Just remember this. Remember this, please. Okay. What it means this? It means when you are students. You read like this. When you grow up, you read like this. A lot of readings. And then when you have a lot of reading, the theory is coming. Okay? So in the initial steps of your reading, you are hanging around and you don't know the theory. You have the keywords of theory. You have the definitions of theory. So theory is like this to you. Something is like this. So the variables are looking like these stars. The theory is coming. When you are reading more, you have connections between them. So you are tying the variables and models in a particular way to understand. You formulate your understanding. يعني أنتوا بتعملوا formulation your understanding. Because when you are reading, you are You are delving in a particular definition, and you are unable to connect this definition or this dimension with the rest of dimensions. يعني بتكونوا انتو مش قادرين تربطوا concepts which is a part of theory, لأنه هذا هو theory كله مع بعض, مش قادرين تربطوهم كلهم مع بعض because you have very little reading. Okay, when you have more reading is like this picture. So we can think on this way. And this is the beauty of reading. If this is this picture, okay, which is R, okay, this R, okay, then before you reading, it's like this. It's blurred. Sorry? حرفك؟ زكفولة عشان حرفة. Okay. Okay, so when you have the initial reading, when you have the initial reading, you have something like this. Okay? And then things should be connected with each other. You try to do like this. You read. Okay, if you read, you can have this. You are reading more. You see this. It's like you see the leg. It's exactly like you have an elephant. When you have an elephant and you are looking to the leg of elephants, you describe the leg as something is not related to elephants. يعني ممكن لو شفتوا بس رجل الإليفنت الفيل هتحكوا عنها شغلة جزء شجرة. Because this leg is disconnected from the elephant body. See? يعني إذا إحنا بس أخذنا this part, okay, this part is anything. Because it's not connected. The more you are reading, it's like, okay.
Like a puzzle.
It's like a puzzle, yes. And the more you read, the more you understand. And the more you connect the bodies of your theory. وكمان تقدروا انه تربطوا كل القصة. So, when I ask students what is your theory, from his or her initial answers, I can examine to what extent he or she reads. إذا أنا بسأل سؤال what is your theory, فأنا بقدر أعرف إنه لوين أنت واسطة في القراءة. And the more I ask you, the more in details I examine your understanding. تمام؟ Well, just to stop. I couldn't answer you. لأن ما تصل لمرحلة sorry. This is okay. My role is to extract your understanding. I try to to decompose the theory. Look. I want to decompose the theory. Okay, this part. Okay, when you read this part, then you have this part. Then you connect this with this, and you have this. Okay, and you have this. So you have the theory. Okay, and some student or some researchers, they just have this. Yeah, just this. Okay, it is not funny things. It's much related to draw the full picture of your research. إنه أنتوا تفهموا الصورة تبعتها. And in the initial starting, it's like something like this. Okay? You don't know. As far as you don't know, it's good starting. يعني المرحلة اللي أنتم بتعرفوش فيها you get lost كويس. At least إنه وضعك شوية حيكون صعب. But people relaxing والناس المبسوطين واللي لسه ما دخلوش يبحثوا as long as you smiling it means you don't read. طالما انتم بتضحكوا معناته انا لسه مش قاريين. لا مش هذا المطلوب، لانه لما انت تقراي وتكتشفي، يعني انا اول ما بقرا اي موضوع قبل بكون مبسوط، يعني انرجيك وبدي اقرا وكاني فاهم القصه كلها.
مش فاهم ايش
بروح باقرا اول ارتكل ثاني ارتكل بحس حالي مش فاهم القصه
انه في كثير معلومات انت
فانا يعني احبط يعني حتى مثلا يعني حتى مثلا المدام بتجيب كاسه الشاي تمام بقول لي الشاي موجود فانا بيكوز ام بيزي ان ريدنج يمكن بعد ساعتين اتذكر انه الشاي موجود انه في شاي ها ليش؟ لأنه خلاص. لكن في الأول لما أنا بدأت الريدنج اللي أنا مش عارف المشكلة اللي أنا فيها، لا أنا ممكن أشرب كاسة وتنتين وثلاثة لأنه I'm enjoying in my ignorant. انتبهوا. I'm enjoying in إيش؟ In my ignorant. I'm talking myself. إنه أنا بستمتع في جهلي. But once my starting or I'm starting my reading, I know it's a big job because many definitions coming and I have to connect between them and starting my journey on reading. This is why if we go back to my little question, do you think addressing the theory is simple or complicated task?
Complicated.
It's complicated. But with the hands of your supervisor, you can reach your destination. مع مساعدة المشرف ممكن تصلوا. Okay? So the theory here, as I mentioned, in deductive, if you have the theory. But unfortunately, the life is not coming like, or the ship. يعني the wind is not coming like the ship wants. يعني الرياح لا تأتي بما تشتهي السفن. Sometimes you don't have the theory. And if you don't have the theory, it means even it is more complicated. إذا إحنا ما عنداش theory بتكون إشي أصعب. What it means you don't have theory, it means you don't have explanations from the previous studies on the current problem. يعني ما فيش عندنا تفسيرات فيش نظريات انعملت لتفسر هذه الظواهر. So this will not always be the case. It may be that your study is based on the principle of developing theory. After data have been collected, then the inductive approach is utilized. Inductive, it's not your is not your work because this is for
high level.
Yes, PhD level and postdoctoral level. Okay, so you can work in the deductive approach. Okay, we'll stop here. Okay, shukran.